Right, so we're going, we were here. All we have to do is move this pointing finger up one to the D.
Alright, so we're going from here to here.
So going. Yeah? So you go from the A to there. Sometimes you get chords which are quite easy to transition from one to the other, that's fine, okay? So that's the verse. So we'll play one time through, and let's see how it works. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, sorry, I'll do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. That's the verse. Now, you will do stuff with your left hand as well. If you're comfortable to try and do two hands, then great. Okay, the way that I play the left hand is really, really simple. If you can try and coordinate the two, that's brilliant. Okay, so I'm going to have to see whether my camera actually goes all the way down. It doesn't. So what you're just going to have to trust me on here, and I might play it up an octave instead, is I'm actually just going to play two notes, and they're going to be an octave apart from each other all the time whenever I do it. So if I happen to go down here, you can see, for example, this finger, this one's not visible right now, I can see from the camera. You can trust that I'm actually playing that. It's the A and the A. I'm not, it looks like I'm pressing something down here, but I'm not with these fingers. Okay? So the way it works is, as I said before, the first chord is the A chord, okay? I'm going to play it up a little bit so you can see it on the camera, although you can't really see that either, which doesn't really help. But for the process of this, what I'm doing is, as I'm doing it, all I'm doing is pressing this down and just holding it, okay? Yeah? Then when we get to the next chord, which was this one, the C sharp minor, I'm moving my thumb and my pinky from the A down to the G sharp. It's just that, okay? So, okay? It might help if you've got a piano or a keyboard that has a sustain pedal, because that note is gonna hold and ring out for a little bit. You can give yourself a little bit more time to get ready for the next one. So rather than going from 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, and suddenly to this, you let it ring out, and you've got lots of time to get ready for the second chord. Okay? So you're going from the A to this G sharp. Next one is the F sharp chord that you're playing. That one. So what we do is we go from the A to the G to the F. Play it slightly differently here. What I'm playing here is it's just different versions of the chord, different bottom notes as such. This is not how the thing actually sounds, but it's just, I think you can see from the camera both my hands if I do this. Okay, so you go from the A to the G to the F, now you're going down to D for your final one, okay? So remember, our chords went A, then there, then we went to the F sharp minor, which was this, and now we're going to the D, so you're moving this finger up here, and you're moving your thumbs down from the F sharp down to the D, like that. Okay? So what that does, that goes like this. Perfect. Okay. So I'll play that through once down here. Play it through with me. If you can only do the right hand for now, that's fine. If you can't do both at the same time, even just try and do left hand on its own, just follow it through, and try and do, so the first one you do is this A chord, then slowly think, okay, well, I've now got to get down with my thumb to the G sharp, and you know from here, you've got to go down here. Just try over and over again, just keep trying until it feels more natural to you. At first, it's not going to, if you've never really done piano before, but eventually it will come to you, and once you find it easy, then you'll find it easy all the time. Right, so we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now, you might have noticed that when I played it, I went from the A to the G, and then I went, I think I went here, is that right? Did I do that? I might not have. I went, how did I go? I can't remember now. Yeah, so I started off with this A here. Notice there's quite a lot of space in between my left and my right hand, so I went, but I can't play up here, doesn't look right. So, because I'm playing my F sharp minor up here, can move my whole left hand up so that I'm starting on this F here. And then the D goes here. So on reflection, it's probably easier as a beginner to go there, 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 there. But if you can, when you get to the F, you go A, G, all the way up to F sharp to D. I'll leave you to practice that as you go along. Right, so I've taken quite a long time doing that. I'm going to teach you very quickly how to do the pre-chorus. Okay, the first chord of the pre-chorus is the E chord, and it's exactly the same premise. So this is the E chord, it's a G sharp, B and E together, and you're using the octaves on the E notes here. F sharp minor as we did before. Then it goes to D again. So. So I think, I don't know the song entirely well, but I think it goes series of four here. Here to F sharp minor, it's quite a difficult transition. You're moving your thumb up one to the A, you're moving your B two up to the C sharp, and your other finger up to the F sharp. So you can go from there to here, okay? Finally, the chorus. So again, this is quite a simple thing. So before we had four chords. That, 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 that. This is almost exactly the same, apart from the second chord is different. So we start with the A again. So it starts exactly the same. Never mind, I'll find. And then the E is the next chord. Find someone like you. Love is nothing but the best. Sound very well, as you can probably guess. So you're going from A to E to F sharp to D. These are no chords that you've not played before, and it's exactly the same four chords as before. Just the instead of doing the C minor, which was the original one in the verse, we're switching down to the B here.